Good morning, students. Welcome back after the examination. So your first periodic, first term is over. Second periodic test is over. Now let's proceed for the next term. But before that, today we are going to have a discussion on nutrition. Nutrition, that is, nutritious diet is the base of life. We all living human beings need good nutrition to sustain ourselves. Okay, when one is having nutritious diet, when enough nutrition goes inside, then mental, physical, emotional, intellectual, all abilities, you know, they are possible. In the absence of nutrition, we may lag behind on all fronts, maybe physical, maybe mental, maybe intellectual, or all. So it's not that it's always the poor who suffer from poor nutrition. Sometimes the people who belong to very, very well-off families, you know, they also suffer from the poor lack of good nutritious diet. What happens? Like many a times, very well-off families, you know, they have got so many things to eat. But in the end, when you talk about the nutrition which might have gone inside their stomachs, that happens to be very, very less. Usually, it is the well-off families only, those who go for supplements. Why is there a need for supplements when the enough nutrition doesn't go inside? Okay. So these, unhealthy foods, junk food items, these things may fill your stomach, but they don't provide the student, children, or the human beings enough nutrition. So nutrition through balanced diet is must for everybody. So in order to have a good balanced diet, one needs to include a sufficient dose of green and leafy vegetables, pulses, dairy products, fruits, all vegetables. Okay, so whatever, you know, different kinds of things you'll eat throughout the day before putting the thing in your mouth, see what nutrition it is giving you. Okay, daily all vitamins and proteins should go inside you. Only then we'll be able to have a good mind, body, and soul. Right? First of all, we must take care of our own diet, the diet of our family. Okay, sometimes mothers, you know, they suffer from the maximum poor nutrition, you know, maximum. They might take care of the whole family. They might take care a lot about the children or their husbands or others. But in the end, when it comes to themselves, they don't take care of themselves. It is maximum women who suffer from anemia or the poor nutrition. And second, it is the children. Why children? Because they are provided sometimes enough by their families, but because their physical output is more, intellectual output is more, so they need more than anybody else. It's a growing up time. The kind of diet the children need during their growing up years, that is more than anyone else. Okay, so children need to be very, very cautious about their nutrition. Okay, everyone in the family, even old people. With age, the kind of nutrition changes. Okay, during childhood, you people may have enough fats because they will all be dissolved because you people are very physically active. But as one starts growing up, because old people are not able to have much physical activities, so their fats intake might be quite less. But yes, green and leafy vegetables, fruits, okay, sufficient quantities of dairy products, they are enough. and try to include variety in your food items. It's not that you just keep one thing daily in your item, just one banana daily or just one apple daily. No, have all colorful items in your plate. Okay, if you have a plate of fruits, try to see the maximum colors inside your plate. Right? Now let's talk about the other section of society, those who are very poor. There are people, those whose physical work is more than what we can even imagine. But the kind of diet they take, that is very, very less or very, very poor in nutrition. So when we have something extra, we can be careful about sharing it with others. Okay? When we can afford enough for ourselves, we can afford a little for sharing also for those who don't have much to eat. I guess you people might be aware of the data, like there are more than 1 million of children, those who go with empty stomachs to sleep. Okay, more than 1 million of children in this world, you know, in this country, you know, they go empty stomach at night. They don't get anything to eat. Okay, and because of that, the kind of diseases, the kind of poor childhood they have, you all know. So not just taking care of ourselves, not just taking care of our family, we must also take care a little bit about the ones, those who are a bit unprivileged. Okay, those who don't afford nutrition. So take care of ourselves and then take care of the others. Okay, what money cannot do, that food can do. Money cannot do everything. Okay, don't always be charitable with the money. Be charitable with food also. Okay, so that is it. So I hope you'll be taking care of yourself as well as others also. So for today, take a pledge to take care of your own diet. Will you? Will you? So make your diet chart. Nutrition chart you make. And see how much you get each day. Right? So it's only a matter of being conscious. It's not a matter of difficulty. It's a matter of being conscious only. Okay, because healthy children means healthy India, and healthy India means a better future for all. That's it with this nutrition. Okay. So set B, what makes a person popular? Yes, option D is correct. Choose the option that best captures the central idea. Yes, Raghav? Straight. Choose the option that best captures the central idea of the passage. So D option is correct here. Success is the sum of small efforts repeated day in and day out by Robert Coyler. No one will speak anything. Sit straight with a 90 degree of angle towards the wall. That is not 90 degree, that is 75 degree, yes. Now it is 90. Yes, you, Gurpal, straight and sit in the center. Center. Raghav, that is an angle of 75 degree. Now it's 90. That's correct. Okay. So which of the following statements stand true in context of the above passage? The boy behind Raghav will tell me the answer. So the answer is option C or and D. Three P's play important role in success, or one should harness his energies to achieve success. And D option is correct, not even C, D. The word obstruction in the passage refers to obstacle. That is D option is correct. On whom does success work? C option is correct. Those who have a proper approach, planning, and vision. Then sixth question, select the option with the underlined words that can suitably replace perseverance. It's B option is correct. A squirrel with continued efforts tried to break the nut through it, though it was hard. Then question number seven, the hummingbirds stayed in the author's house from May till September because C option. The following months were quite cold at the author's place. Eighth question, I couldn't believe my eyes. You people don't have this set. I couldn't believe my eyes. Why does the author make this above remark? So let me not solve the passage because many of you don't have the question papers. Today you all will first solve the set A and B comprehensions, all of you. Set A and set B's comprehensions, you all will solve. Maybe you people did this in the paper also. Okay, but maybe if you had A set, even then you will resolve set A. Set A and B both should be done on your FAIR notebooks today. FAIR. And tomorrow in the class, we will discuss and you will tick the answers or you will correct them. Right? So I'm leaving this these questions now, 7th onwards. Let's come to grammar part. Grammar also you do on your own first. Literature we can discuss today. Okay, do all section A and B on your notebooks today of both of the sets and literature we. I'll send the paper in your. Okay. Literature section C. So how does Evelyn hear the music? What's the option? D. That is all parts of body. What happens to Evelyn's body when she listens to music? D. D option, that is felt the vibrations travel. Give the meaning of the word resonances. It's a D option is correct. That is reverberate. Then who is the poet thinking of? Now in my memory comes my mother and all. His mother, that is A option is correct. Darling dreamers is an example of transferred epithet, that is C option. What is the meaning of refrain in the passage? Yeah, in this passage, refrain means repetition. In this passage, the word has been written and that refrain means the repetition. Let me check. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in many years agone. As she left them till the dawn, oh, I feel her fond look on me. As I list to this refrain, song. It should be song, not B option, C. Meaning is asked, not poetic device. So meaning is song. B option is correct, okay? 33rd. When the poet is saying, oh, I feel her fond look on me. What does he mean? He means look of his mother that was once her daily part of life. That is D option. Got it? Then 33rd D answer is correct. Now 34. Who is the disconsolate charge? What's the answer? The lost child. That is B option. Jaskaran, which set you had? Very nice. It is B only. Write down the answers with you. Very nice. Who is the man here? What's the answer? Yeah, D option, the man who tried to console the child, crying child. Which quality of man is displayed in the above extract? did you find the meaning of these words? Altruistic. What did you do? Trustworthy is also correct, and B option was basically correct. Altruistic. So all of you find the meaning from dictionary of these words: austere, altruistic, trustworthy. I guess you know, and infallible. Infallible. But do you know the meanings of these words? If no, then today you check. Read the extracts and answer the questions. What good deed was done by this fellow? Helping the playwright or match girl? Yes, C option is correct. Why did this fellow feel warm?
Heartfelt.
Yeah, B answer is correct. Heartfelt contentment. What is contentment? Good. What does the narrator want to convey? C option is correct, yes. Okay, then Panchayat was revived back in a new form by a? C option is correct. What is the bureau of theoretical physics? It's a D option is correct. Research papers contained in the drawers. Or a project. I guess C and D both have been checked. C and D both are correct. Okay. Okay. Then Kingdom of Fools. Just a minute. Stand up these boys. Gurupal and other. Stand up both of you. All of you become quiet. Jaskaran and this boy. Stand up. You also stand up. Chalo, you just Karan, come here. Hurry up. You go there and Gurpal, you come here. And first venture, what's your name? Ishan, you go there and you come here. Sit down. Straight face towards the wall. And it can happen when you're sitting in the center. Kingdom of Fools is a story which is written as per the norms of satire. S-A-T-I-R-E. The destructive power of wind in the poem. Wind is a symbol of
challenges.
Even, you know, challenges. Parenting is also a skill. It is providing efficient and adequate emotional and social support to young ones. So Kezia actually required the skill on part of her parents. So of the following example, which skill is not applicable? It's A answer is correct. A is correct over here. Okay. Then 45th. The poem Legend of Northland is a story told from generation to generation. And it is a ballad. A option. Okay. Then whose words did Abdul Kalam's father quoted? Khalil Gibran. Okay. So 47th question. Why were the king and minister considered as fools?
Rule in a just manner.
B option is correct. They were not able to rule in a just manner. Yes, maybe A and B both might be correct. That you see, because the checkers, I don't know what, but B was basically correct. Evelyn accomplished great heights. Stand up, you. The problem is with you, not with others, I guess. I changed this person even when you are talking. That boy doesn't talk much. You talk a lot. Then? Very bad. After this, the seat will be outside. Sit down. Okay. So she accomplished great heights. It was because of her dedication and determination. C option is correct. So Albert was called as a brother Boring because
he was feeling everything twice.
Yeah, because he likes to play alone. When somebody speaks everything twice, then that person will be an entertainer for you. You won't call him boring. For you, the boring person is the one who doesn't interact much with you. Right? So try to think always. Which of the following includes the message of the chapter, My Childhood? Here, option B was correct. That is tolerance, broad-mindedness, and acceptance. That's it. So A and B sections you people solved today. Okay. 50th, अभी तो बताया B option. गलत हो गया? Okay. Yeah, set A also I have. So C, it's a section. Laksh Taneja. Is there Dhruv in your class? No, I guess 11th standard child has come. Yes, Dhruv beta, what are you doing here? Attend your maths class. Yeah, he left. So section C, literature. So what does the poet mean by saying, now I am discussing set A. What does the poet mean by saying, looked down as far as I could? Yes, children, tomorrow after the paper, when you get any doubt, you can go to either Indrajit ma'am or Baljeet ma'am or Shweta. Okay, don't come to me. But yes, if your problem will not be sorted out, you can come to me. Okay, basically there might not be any problem. Read one of the extracts given below and answer the questions that follow. So what does the poet mean by saying looked down as far as possible? So here C and D options are correct. Yeah, both are correct. Looked till his sight reached to a long distance, or looked as far as he could and waited for some time. Then yellow is symbolic of autumn season. What do the roads represent? Huh? Choices. Okay. So 30th, C option is correct. C. Then 31st, it's also C option correct. What happened when the pages of the book are torn? So the pages get corrugated. Find the word from the passage which means the same as genuine, real, that is C option. So 33rd, A option. What was the state of mind of Tommy and Margie when they found a book? Answer is surprised. Some children have the problem. I'll tell you tomorrow. Today I'm going to call Jaskaran's mother. Rest I will see later on. How to sit? What's the rule? What's the rule I've told you to sit?
90 degrees towards the wall.
You must sit at an angle of 90 degree, and from there your face can turn towards me. But when you're sitting at an angle of 70 degree or 75 degree at the back side, what does it mean? What does it mean? Something wrong? You don't know which set you had in your paper. You don't have any question paper. You don't have any notebook in your hand. You don't have a pen in your hand. What does it mean? What does it mean? And you are looking back always. What does it mean? We will confirm from your parents. One can say something once, twice, thrice. Your seat has also been changed. Even then you are doing the same thing. Can't you keep a pen and notebook in your hand? Go and bring your bag. And that second last pencil. Yes, stand up you. Yes. Did you sleep at night? No? Why? Where were you? Of course, if you were not at home, you had gone outside. But where? But where? Why? When did you come back? You came at 4 o'clock. Then why didn't you take rest at home? Why didn't you take rest at home? Then why are you sleeping here? Head, keeping your head down in the class is not a rule. Sit down. Don't think that when you are able to answer each question, you are very nice. Quiet. Before letting others actually point out your mistake, say sorry in the beginning. Well, children, tomorrow we'll continue.